Welcome to GPC Online Learning. In this video, we are going to study about three-phase energy meters. In previous video, we are discussing about single-phase energy meter and what is its important and how it is going to work. Now we are going to discuss about three-phase energy meter. Induction type three-phase energy meters are commonly used to measure the energy supplied to the three-phase circuit. A single-phase energy meter we are using to measure supply in single phase. Three-phase energy meter we are going to use to measure the electrical energy supplied through a three-phase system. Construction of three-phase energy meter is similar to single-phase energy meter. The three-phase energy meter and single-phase energy meter in construction wise both are same. Only the difference is here we will have three current coils and three pressure coils. In case of single-phase energy meter, we have one current coil and one pressure coil. In three-phase energy meter, we will have three current coils and three pressure coils. We already discussed about single-phase energy meter. It is going to have one pressure coil. Like this, one pressure coil will be there. This is the pressure coil, and we are going to keep one current coil. Between these, we are going to place the disc. This is going to give us the driving torque. Okay. This is a pressure coil, or we can say voltage coil. And this one is the current coil. If we see three-phase energy meter, it is going to have three pressure coils and three current coils. We can see in diagram. See, this is the pressure coil 1 and current coil 1. Pressure coil 2, current coil 2. Pressure coil 3, current coil 3. Here, all these are connected. You can see R, Y, B, neutral. R, Y, B and neutral phase. Here you can see the neutral is taken here directly. It is connected here. But if you see the input side, R is connected to here and same R is taken to the R phase is given to the primary coil and pressure coil and current coil. From pressure coil, it is taken and it is connected in a common. You can see this is the pressure coil. From R, Y, B, pressure coil is connected to three phases, and from load side, it is shorted. It is given to the neutral. And each phase RYB is connected to 1-1 current transformers. You can see this to three phase load. From here we are connecting to load. Here you can see the diagram easily. See, this is first current coil, second current coil, third current coil, respectively connected to RYB, and it is the pressure coils also connected in similar manner. For each phase there is one pressure coil, and finally that pressure coil is connected to, you can see here, to each phase we have connected one pressure coil. This pressure coil is connected to neutral at the load side. This is the connection for three phase energy meter. Now we'll see how an electronic energy meter is going to work and what is this. This meter also called as solid state energy meter. These meters commonly utilize a potential transformer connected to the power lines as a voltage sensor for producing an electrical voltage signal proportional to the load voltage, and a current transformer connected to the power line as a current sensor for producing an electrical voltage signal proportional to the load. This electronic energy meter is going to have one potential transformer and current transformer. This potential transformer and current transformer both are connected from the supply. Supply is like this, phase and neutral. From here it is connected. Okay, here it will include, this is a potential transformer, and one more is connected like this. This is a current transformer. From potential transformer we are getting a signal, that is voltage signal with respect to the load voltage. Load mein hum log jitna voltage de raha hai wo voltage yahan ye electronic energy meter ko supply kiya jayega, aur load mein kitna current ja raha hai wo current ke anusar ek aur signal bhi electronic energy meter ko diya jayega. These small signals are then energy consumption and display it on the screen of the display unit. So based on these signals, these are going to recorded inside the energy meter, and this will be displayed in display unit. Jo hum log voltage potential transformer ke द्वारा वोल्टेज दे रहा है, करंट ट्रांसफार्मर के द्वारा करंट एक और सिग्नल दे रहा है, ये दोनों सिग्नल को यूज करके वो रिकॉर्ड करेगा और एनर्जी को कैलकुलेट करेगा, फाइनली डिस्प्ले यूनिट में डिस्प्ले करेगा. यहां हम देख सकते हैं कि ये है इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एनर्जी मीटर. Here you can see this is a phase and neutral. These two are connected to the load. In this same line, here you can see this is the potential transformer, or we can say voltage transformer. This is going to give voltage scaling network. This is a voltage scaling network. This potential transformer will give voltage signal. Voltage signal to the voltage scaling network. This voltage scaling network will simplify the voltage signal, or we can say it will scale it down. Hum log ko yahan maan lijiye 230 voltage aa raha hai. ये 230 वोल्टेज से ये सैंपल लेगा, लेकिन हम लोग को जितना चाहिए, मान लीजिए केवल 5 वोल्ट चाहिए काम करने के लिए, वहां तक ये स्केल डाउन करेगा. करंट ट्रांसफार्मर जो है ये केवल फेस में कनेक्ट किया जाएगा. क्यों? केवल फेस में हम लोग को करंट आएगा. ये फेस को हम लोग स्केलिंग, करंट स्केलिंग नेटवर्क से कनेक्ट किया है. ये ही, ये भी इसका वोल्टेज मतलब लेवल को स्केल डाउन करेगा. स्केल डाउन करने के बाद वोल्टेज सिग्नल और करंट सिग्नल ये दोनों एनालॉग मल्टीप्लायर को दिया जाएगा। यहाँ से ये VCO को और एनालॉग टू डिजिटल कन्वर्टर को दिया जाएगा। ये प्रोसेस होने के बाद फाइनली डिस्प्ले यूनिट कितना एनर्जी खर्च हो रहा है वो डिस्प्ले करेगा। We'll see operation. Above figure shows the simple schematic block diagram of digital energy meter. हम लोग पिछले स्लाइड में देखा है। The potential transformer used as a voltage sensor steps down the line voltage to a suitable level. The potential transformer input side we are giving 220 or 230 in general. This is a 220 volt, 220 volt for single phase distribution. Single phase distribution. We are giving this 220 volts to the potential transformer that will step down to a suitable level. हम लोग को कौन सा अच्छा होगा level, वो level तक वो देगा। The current transformer used as a current sensor. The current in the line and converts it to corresponding voltage signal. Current transformer is also going to take out the current signal and it will convert to a suitable voltage signal. Okay. Then both this voltage and current signals are further downscaled to the suitable level using voltage and current scaling network and then applied as input to an analog multiplier. So these are taken like this. There we saw in diagram. This is the voltage transformer, or we can say potential transformer. It is given to the scaling network and current transformer is also given to the scaling network. These will step down and these two are applied to a analog multiplier. Here we are giving these two signals to the analog multiplier. Next, the analog multiplier produces output signal in the form of a DC voltage. This analog multiplier is going to give us the output DC signal proportional to the product of its two input signals. हम लोग जितना दे रहा है वोल्टेज कितना है और करंट कितना है, वोल्टेज और करंट ये दोनों के अनुसार ये क्या कर रहा है, वोल्टेज और करंट के अनुसार क्या करेगा, ये मल्टीप्लायर जो है एनालॉग मल्टीप्लायर एक सिग्नल को प्रोड्यूस करेगा। हिंस द आउटपुट सिग्नल, जस्ट अ सेकंड, हिंस द आउटपुट सिग्नल प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द एनालॉग मल्टीप्लायर इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द इंस्टेंटेनियस वैल्यूज ऑफ लाइन वोल्टेज एंड लाइन करंट। हमारे पास जितना वोल्टेज है और जितना करंट है ये दोनों के बेस करके ये एक सिग्नल को प्रोड्यूस करेगा। इट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द इंस्टेंटेनियस इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर फ्लोइंग थ्रू द लाइंस, दस वी हैव। यहाँ लाइन में जितना वोल्टेज जा रहा है, जितना करंट जा रहा है उसके अनुसार ये प्रोड्यूस करेगा इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल को। That is VDC is directly proportional to V into I, that is directly proportional to power. मतलब यहाँ जो सिग्नल आ रहा है हम लोग को DC सिग्नल वो कैसे आएगा, कितना वोल्टेज दे रहा है और कितना करंट आ रहा है। We have a formula power equals to voltage into current. This is how it is going to calculate the power and if you multiply power with time we will get it energy. how much electrical energy we are going to consume. Here you can see the single phase digital energy meter diagram. This is having different parameters to be displayed in display unit. This one we call display unit. This is a display. And here we are going to give phase connection, phase, and this is the neutral connection. From here we are taking this to the load. This is the phase, and from here we are connecting this to the load neutral. This is input side, this is load side. So inside the meter it is going to calculate how much it is given. Here we can see kilowatt hour. This is the energy, how much we are going to spend. Here you can see this meter is having 5 years warranty. So this is how it is going to be. This is the electronic energy meter. Thank you.